Okay, so I said I'd do that thing where I introduce the planners. And when I'm trying to find where I have all of these old planners stashed, like the ones I'm not using, you know, that I purchased like last year for this year, or I've already purchased this year to use and I never really did, I found 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that is not including the notebooks. Like the Scribbles That Matter notebooks. I have 3 of those unopened, 4 of them opened. And we're not talking about like the dot grid notebooks I've ordered, like, you know, custom ones that I've ordered throughout the past couple years or anything like that. We're just custom covered notebooks that I've ordered. We haven't discussed those, and we're not going to discuss the covers either, because I have a slight obsession with getting custom covers. When you're a planner person and you're looking at the same planner for a year, or sometimes 18 months, you want to customize your cover. So what I'll do is this first little section is going to be planners I liked, but a couple of them I might actually go back into and use a little bit. Excuse me. But others, I regret buying them just because I thought they were going to be great for me and then they just didn't work out. So that'd be great for me. I was like, all right, a planner I can keep in my purse, use as a wallet, and I'm going to be good to go. Which is the Hobonichi. Let me take it out of its cover thing. Oh, that was my little list thing. Oh, this was me keeping track of everything I was doing in a day. Hobonichi Teko, which is one I got. Okay. And it was on the first page. I didn't even need to take it out of this little cover. But I got mine on Amazon. Like, most of my stuff, if I order it from Amazon, I mean, order it online, it goes from Amazon, except for my plum papers. Those ones I'm okay with ordering straight online and having no issues with. But I loved, like, the way the Hobonichi looks. Like, with, like, the graph grid stuff. And I like the way the months are set up, where the months are at the beginning. That reminds me of another planner I have somewhere. I can't go grab, because I don't know where I put it. But the bullet planner. I have the bullet planner. Didn't like that at all. That just, I didn't like the way that was set up. I didn't like the way the weeks and stuff were set up. I'm a little too anal about it. And then this is a 15 month plum paper. Let me find a month that hasn't been touched. Ooh, cold. Okay. June. Because I haven't used it in June. And this is what their monthly looks like. It's really pretty. I mean, I love it, and I was actually kind of excited to get an Erin Condren this year because they had their note pages, but they got rid of them for the 2019. But because I love the note pages for June. Well, for plum paper. And then this one is lines only, which I love. I love the lines only. It's just it got too freeform for me, and maybe I can show you how I was using it. I'm trying to find one that's actually like semi-filled out, because I got lax. Very lackadaisical at the end of it. But I would decorate my months and then fill those out. Palm Oak Paper is who did those kits. I'll link, there's one that's filled out. I will link like stores and stuff like that for everything as much as I can, because, you know, some of the stuff isn't available anymore. But this is how I like would fill it out. Like this is a Planning Made Easy weekly kit. Like down the side I would always cover up the month at a glance because I hated that. And then I would do like my running task for the week, and then I would track either like my steps, my eating, my calories that I've been taking, my calories that I burned, workouts I did, This was during 80 Day Obsession. Yep, 80 Day Obsession. Like, I was tracking, like, the shakes that I had, that's what these little boxes were for, and then the workout, which was how long it was, my resting heart rate, my maximum, or my average heart rate, my maximum heart rate, how many calories I burned, what workout I did. And what happened was, is it started getting too confining. Sometimes I would have too much, like, why did I get to leave early that day? I don't know, but I ended up leaving early a day. Hey, that's when I got my S8. January 30th. Huh, cool. Good to know. That's what I'm recording this on. But that is literally how I did all my months. And then this is like how I used like the note page kit that came with the palm oak paper. And then I tried other stuff and I just fell apart. Oh, like here's one. March 27th, that's when I had my oral surgeon consultation. April 17th, I had my oral surgery. Okay, oops. Trying to figure out where to put paper and stuff. And then another planner I tried was the Kit Life Planner, which is it's a daily planner. And I liked it. It's just, it's huge. This is just 1 year. And I'm, as you saw, a sticker person. Like I tried, this looked awful. I hated how I did it. And I think that's what killed me on it was like, I tried to sticker it up. And but I was like, bleh. Ooh, I worked a double that day, Monday, March, February 5th. But I'm trying to see if there's any other days where I actually did fill it out. Yeah, kind of sort of filled it out, but I didn't do as much with it as I thought I could or would, so this was kind of a waste of money, and I feel bad. And here's another waste of money. Cindy reviewed she reviewed the work one, and I was like, oh, this is actually going to be good. I can work on goals because I was thinking of doing more with beach body and stuff like that. Like, so I was working on like my State of the Union. That's as far as I got. But it's like best memories of 2017 of making full time, St. Louis, my mom and my family. What times was spent learning new skills, spending time with family in St. Louis. What did you accomplish or complete? Made full time. Finally joined beach body as a coach. I joined as a coach. Right now, I'm just doing it as a, for the discount. What was money well spent? Shakeology, Energize, new Keurig. I bought a smaller, I actually downsized my Keurig. And that was actually very much money well spent. Because I don't have as much issue, I don't have the issues with, like, mildew and stuff going in my little thing. Because it's smaller. And I can only, like, brew, like, 2 cups of coffee at a time before I need that. And then new blenders. I bought a travel one. Just a single serve travel one, Hamilton Beach, I think is brand. And then I got a Ninja Fit, which is the cheaper version of the Nutra Ninja. Uses all the same things as the Nutra Ninja, but cheaper. And making progress on big life goals in 2017? Not really, no. My goal was to like lose a certain amount of weight and stuff like that. And then it's like, what is working? What felt successful about 2017? What did you learn about yourself? I'm a big old chicken. I let fear rule me, which is why I'm doing Vlogust. Because I'm like, I never finish. I'm going. If I could prove to myself I can do this, I can do almost anything. Did you overcome any obstacles? Just the fear of failure. I'm doing pretty good at that. The biggest thing for me was applying for that full-time position. I was scared to death because I had just gotten a write-up for having my cell phone. By the boss who's constantly got her cell phone on her now. she and I have made good now. So that's good. Who nurtured and supported you? Josh, and then Ashley, my beach body coach. And then now, like, the rest of the team. I just love it. Who did you enjoy nurturing and supporting? And then my kids. And then that's as far as I got, so I didn't even do anything. So I might use this for 2019 to build my goals for 2019. My biggest thing for 2018 was my year, my word for the year was focus, which obviously doesn't look like I have much focus, but this is the whole point of why when I show you the planners that are working for me, why focus is coming into play. Because, and it's even my year in the word, my word, very much so, it's on my right there. Somebody asked me before, because when I show off pictures of my Fitbit, there's always, you always see the picture of the bracelet, which says, which is a washer that says focus. Now, you're wearing a washer on your wrist? Technically, yes. It's from myintent.org. But 2018, I finally got the diagnosis, the official diagnosis of ADHD. I've been trying to get this diagnosis since I was like 18. Probably longer than that, because my doctor actually... Sorry, meds make my mouth really dry. My doctor basically told me, no, you don't have bipolar. It's like you might have, you might have hormonal fluctuations, but you don't have bipolar. You have ADHD. And as a teenager with ADHD and things, and she agreed with PTSD. So ADHD and PTSD from very rocky childhood. But if I would have gotten that diagnosis of ADHD a long time ago, I think a lot of the stuff that I dealt with as a teenager might not have happened, which is why I'm like so focused on making sure Ethan's okay. But he hasn't had any of the, he has a few of like my normal little symptoms of hyper focuses and can't focus on things he doesn't really enjoy and stuff like that. But he doesn't have any of the, because he's had such a really damn good childhood, because mine sucked so bad. I'm doing everything in my power to make sure my kids have a good one. He doesn't have any of the emotional instabilities that come with that, with PTSD. So, yay. Okay, now, back to the planners, because, okay, the one that is working, one of the ones that is working for me is, it's a, just a basic ring bound, ooh, hit myself in the face, recollections. Got it from Michaels. I ordered online because I never have it in the stores. And of course, now that I go into, when I go into the store now, there's a huge collection of them all the time. But I keep it here because I like this because, one, I can organize. Like, here I've got my 2B mindset notes that I took. I took those. I took a bunch of notes while I was watching the videos introducing it, and then I recopied it into little papers, and I used fitness stickers and stuff like that from Happy Planner, me and my big ideas, to decorate it. So it makes it, stickers help me focus. See, focus. And then I've got the Make Today Count, and then I've got the Perpetual Calendar, which I haven't quite figured out how I'm going to use those Perpetual Calendars, but I'm going to use those in 2019 when I do figure it out. I think it's going to be like a daily gratitude and a this is what happened today kind of thing, because I have several different ones. But I do the months two different, like, different ways. Like this one, created using scrap kits from Ginger Scraps. And then we're not going to show the things that didn't work, but just weekly pages. See, not everything, because, like, see, I got a couple dailies. Those are back in May. And then more June. Used, that's it from Planning Made Easy, the subscription box. You got the mega one. And then it jumps to, I have no idea what day it is. Oh, this is July, I think. No, this was June. This is still June. So I'm like, I see Java City in it. It's like, no, it's not July. But I didn't quite use it all the way, but I was following like themes from Quirky Heart, part of her Patreon thing. And then here comes July. Didn't really use it much for July, like, at all. Designed a page, printed on the dot grid, because I have plenty of dot grid paper, but I also have two unopened reams of A5 paper, because I like the A5, and it's actually working for me. And then, just a couple, one's like, I tried a meal plan. See, I have two more notebooks there, too, that I don't have out. I have a wellness planner from Erin Condren and the meal plan from Erin Condren. Which those were basically for my purse. And then one weekly layout for July, I think it was. Yeah, maybe two. Yeah, two. Two layouts for July. And then August, I set up my back to school shopping list. One for my son, one for my daughter. It's written in pencil so I can edit as needed. And then, I didn't show off the, and then there's the weekly. I use these, the stickers are from the teacher sticker book from Me and My Big Ideas. The washi is, I think it's the Walmart ones that they've got. And their student, and their back to school section. And then Me and My Big Ideas stickers. But I love, my favorite thing is this right here. The little pins, because it kind of looks like they're, you know, pinned. So it's like, fix Maddie's schedule, dentist, we had a dentist, kids had a dentist appointment on Tuesday. It's a new month, so set up a new month. Newsletter that I had to write for the Fresh Baked for Friday. Vlog has started, rent was due, and then log books read. Read one book for August, which is pretty good. And then I set up my daily for today. We're gonna see how those dailies go. I have my quirky heart and it's just a notebook packets from those two that I support in Patreon. Then I have my not so berry legacy for Sims 4 because I want to do that. And then I have digital photography, phone photography class thing that I'm taking, class that I'm doing with Persnickety Prints. And then I have trackers that I did, like a fitness tracker that I need to finish filling out. And then just the little notebook papers that everything come, that they come with. But this, because I can if it's out of, or it's reason the notebooks didn't work for me, is I can't reorganize based on how my brain is functioning at the time. Like, I have the dividers in here, and I can reorganize as I need, and that I need. Okay, so that's that one. And then this one I got at Walmart. I was like so excited to see Happy Planners at Walmart. I didn't realize it was horizontal, and I'm not quite sure how I want to use a horizontal. Like, I haven't figured it out at all, but I got, like, their gift box thing. So I've got, like, two folders there. Then I've got a bunch of folders in the back with, I've only got until December in here, and then I have, like, the rest of the year sitting in a bag and one of my storage cubes. And then I've got a folder here with, this is do all the things for, and then today and tomorrow, which is a bunch of those. And then I have just another folder, and I love this print notebook paper, another folder, a notes thing, which has a bunch of paper, and then a little dashboard with graph paper, and that was it. Yeah. And then I also, in one of my storage cubes, I have a stack of the single, that like half sheet notes. And then I think I got a, trying to see if I have one of these that are, no, it's not really blank, it's been used. But I also have a bunch of these, they're hourly add-ins So it's got like the place for the date, priorities. Get it done by the hour. And then on the back is a page for brain dumps. Oh, and I forgot right there. A section for grateful, for things to be grateful for. Those I only use like on days where I need to maintain a schedule. Like I have stuff that has to be done at a certain time. Those are great for that. And they slide right into this one. Or I think they should. I'm going to test real quick. Yep, the sizing is the exact same. For the spacing, I should say, for this one, even though it's a lot bigger, which is good. That means my dashboards and stuff would work in this one too. But I kept seeing these wellness planners, and everybody's got them as an add-on, and I'm like, you see how thick this thing is. And that's with me only having July through December in here. So it's like, it's massive, massively thick. And I'm like, that I cannot add another section. Because I like, I would love to add like the fitness section in there and add all this into it. It's like, it's too thick. They don't make rings. They don't make these things big enough, even for, so I'm like, So what I did is I found, just want to show you that they do fit in this. Take it off though. I didn't realize this was the big, huge, honking one. This is the large Happy Planner, but it's their wellness version. But I love the cover of it. Oh my God. It says, choose where your energy goes. I just love how it looks. And I love the silver. But it's, I'm going to go into one where I haven't started filling anything out. This one is my keeping track of like headaches, keeping track of moods, keeping track of hormone related stuff, keeping track of if I decided to take my temperature because I felt like butt, keeping track of my sinus issues. This is literally my wellness tracking. So this is the month. It's very, very colorful. I love the purple though. The purple is so pretty. Like it's got a section for my happy list on this one. I think, I don't know if every month is different. Nope, every month says my happy list. And then each week has like, you know, the little, this I love because there's a productivity sticker set. If I have it right on top, I'll show it. Okay, even if I don't have it right on top, I think I'll show it. It is on top, I think it got shoved in the back on top. Ooh, so many sticker books. It's in here. I swear. Oh, well. The Moxie Dory stencil stuff. Student. That's, the student icon one is actually, I bought a lot of student related sticker books. Where is it? Oh my goodness gracious. This is seasonal. It's right here, isn't it? Nope, that's fitness. I have like 6 fitness books. I am not kidding. The fitness stickers from Happy, Me and My Big Ideas are definitely my go-to ones. Where did it go? Where's that productivity book? Did I miss it? Tiny, fitness, seasonal, memory keeping, food, memory, happy memory keeping, planner basics, productivity, right on top like I said it was. Okay, let's put these back in there. Because I have to get into the, but I found the sidebars that I'm obsessed with. There they are. Like, these ones. I'm obsessed with these sidebars, and I love them. So when I saw these sidebars for the wellness plan, I was like, oh yeah, what I need. Like, yeah. You got like a place for exercise, how I spent time unplugged, and I think, are they all unplugged? What my intuition is telling me, how I showed kindness this week, how I honored myself this week, and I think that's all of them. Yep. There we go. And then positive vibes, reading, listening to, feeling, and watching. And I love, and then you've got like, they're not really divided in any way, and then you do have these little dot, or not dot grid, graph sections. That's reflection. Today was thankful for, and it's like, focus on looking forward, no, inward, I'm sorry, daily gratitude and joy of today. And I think all of them are this, yeah, all of them, those ones are the same. And I'm like, that is what I need. I need reminders of that kind of stuff too. And if I can't think of anything to actually put, I can put like a picture, print out a picture and tape it down, glue it down, whatever. Or I can stick a sticker that kind of shows it. Ugh. But I just got this one. So I took out July and I haven't really used it. I need to go back and fill it out for this past week because this past week sucked. So I need to keep track of that stuff. And then this one I got reminded about. I've only got a few months left in it because it's, you know. But it's the mini fitness planner by Happy Planner. And then there's, you know, month at a glance thing. They have a little quote on the end of each month. Attitude is everything. It always seems impossible until it's done. And then a weekly food and exercise log for like, oh, here's just, it's the same on all sides. You got for breakfast, your snacks, your lunch, another snack, your dinner, your calorie totals, your exercise, with plenty of like writing information down, like all your stats or whatever, and then place to log your water. I'm gonna put it there because that way it's not blinding the light. But it's like, it's super, super tiny. And then you've got the end of each month, you've got the spot for a progress selfie, where you can do how I was successful, how do I feel, what didn't go so well, what can I do differently, what motivates me, and I give myself how many stars out of 5. And I love that. And I love, like, they have these awesome quotes and stuff like that at the beginning of each month. And I love that. So I might, in 2019, look for another one of these. Or continue using, because I also have a full-size one. You can't really tell what it is because I changed the cover on it. But this is the wellness planner from Michaels. It's undated. And it comes with, they come with like stickers and stuff for it to date it and everything like that, which I love. But completely undated and with a note section. We've got a, okay, we'll go this way. Okay. Well, maybe I won't use this because it looks like I decorated. I got a few months left in it. Okay. Undecorated. Trying to get this. Here we go. Undated. You've got a place for your meals. I'll go over here. I can't see what I'm doing. Your meals, your glasses of water, your health, your hours of sleep, your weekly goals. You can put like a quote there. You can do like a task list there. Or notes on how the day is going. And then you have another little spot for a quote or a sticker or something. And then you have your healthy habit tracker there. And then random week in the middle of it. This page is a mess up on this, their planner, which I'm not surprised. But then you get a monthly review, so you get you set your goal, and then your reflection on how your goal went, and give yourself 4 out of 5 stars, and you got enough spots for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 goals. So that's pretty cool. And I had one of the ones from, you know, the 2017 one that they did, where they messed up and only gave like 4 weeks per month, and it messed up. And there wasn't enough months for the year, weeks for the year. So that was fun. And then the final one that has actually become the one I use the most often. I didn't think I'd ever use it. When I first became part of the planner world, I bought an Erin Condren. I was one of those ones who got their credit card skimmed on my second order. And to make matters worse on that one, my order was screwed up and it took them 3 times to fix it. With no credits or anything like that. They was like, we can credit you or we can send it. And I'm like, I ordered it for a reason. But the fact of paying $13.95 for shipping when they're doing FedEx to post office, when I know it doesn't cost that much for the stuff that they were shipping, because it was just like a little flat mailer and they were charging $13.95 flat shipping. So I knew some people were getting a really good deal in their shipping. I was getting screwed. So I was like, screw it, not doing it anymore, especially after how they handled the credit card skimming issues. They're saying it wasn't them. I never had any issues since. But anyway, I haven't had any issues since. Knock on wood. But I found out that they have a storefront on Amazon and I can use my Prime. So I was like, so I ordered an Erin Condren. $18 for actually cheaper than what they have it on their site, which is weird. And I didn't have to pay any shipping because I have Prime. So, because I love like the dashboard, and I got a neutral. I don't want their colorful. That was another thing that set me off. It's like, I hated the colorful. And I use in the pockets for little mini stickers that I have. But yeah. And I got the hourly. Because it kind of works for me. Because my work starts at 8 or 6 a.m. and I go straight till 8. So, and finishes at 8. Woohoo! Knocked off my glasses. So that's what I've been using. And then Planning Made Easy. Whatever it's called. Thing. And then I use Subscription Kit. That's the word I was looking for. And then that's what I used for this past week. Was the July kit, I think it was. But I like it. And then I've got all these things for where I was going to work out, and I did it because of migraine, and I had a call into work, and my Thursday was my dad's birthday, and I was so just not. I didn't text him until yesterday. It was his 60th birthday. But he understands. It's one thing I like about my dad. But the one thing with the Erin Condren that I don't like is get rid of the notes section. And I'm actually sad about that. So, let me see. That's what I did. I still used it and still have my habit tracker, which I need to fill out. But those are my planners, and I've gone like 30 minutes on this, so. Anyway. I think that's it, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.